weather conditions here, and we'll bring in a slight chance of some thunderstorms as we head towards Wednesday with a high of 83 degrees. Chris?
All right, thanks, CT. Well, with school back in session, students are back in sports, and preventing injuries is so important. That's why joining us today is one of our health link experts, Dr. Scott McMullen. Now, thank you so much for joining us this midday.
Well, thank you for having me.
Now, I guess the number one thing would be shoes.
Running shoes are very, very important. That's certainly the main equipment that we need in addition to the environment around us. Running shoes should be what feels comfortable and what fits, and that varies depending on a person's individual foot anatomy. Running shoes should also be changed as they wear. Given several hundred miles, 300-400 miles of wear, probably time for a new pair of shoes. If you don't keep track of your miles, 9 to 12 months, and then probably time for a new pair.
Okay, because I was telling you earlier that I've had my tennis shoes now for almost a year, so it's almost time to change them out.
Probably time to do a little shopping.
All righty. Well, what's some other tips you have? Let's see, build up to the mileage.
It's important to go very, very gradual. Whether you're a new runner or a seasoned veteran looking to increase the miles, make that transition very, very slowly. Mm-hmm. Take periods of rest. Run a day or two. Have a rest day. Run a day or two. And just try and make that transition somewhat gradual.
And it's also good, you say, to vary your training?
If you can vary the type of running that you do, also look for surfaces that are more forgiving. A soft cushion surface mm-hmm. is helpful. As you're increasing miles or starting running as a new process, avoid hills. That extra stress and strain on the feet, ankles, and knees can be problematic.
I was about to say, whenever I run at least, my ankles start hurting really bad. Should we wrap our ankles or anything?
Well, not
like
necessarily.
That?
The key things with any type of physical activity in the lower extremities is to stretch. Stretching is so important. And so with the running process, a warm-up, a period of stretching, and the running activity, and then the cool down and stretching again at the end. That helps the body to repair the damage that's been done during the athletic activity.
And I also heard that the core is very important, to build up the core.
Certainly we want to focus on all the structures, and so maintaining good core strength and good core flexibility can help our extremities to function better as well.
So that's basically just doing the